Hi guys, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Pieter Koornhof and I've been asked by the organising committee of this year's nationals to do a bit of an introductory workshop regarding just common methods of legal analysis and legal argumentation. I know not all of us are law students, but the unfortunate nature of debating and public discourse is that often we are thrown into motions where we need to talk about things we don't necessarily know or study about. So it's a good idea to just equip everyone with certain basic tools. Like in any debate, it's always a good idea to know some laws, some political theory, some economics. So I'm not going to be looking at economics or political theory. I'll be looking at something I at least, will pretend to know something about. The first thing that is very important when making legal argumentations or having being in a motion where you need where the law is relevant is you need to, as a debater, be able to distinguish between arguing within the law and arguing about the law. Now, that's essentially the difference between lawyering and debating. Jurists, lawyers, advocates tend to argue within the law. They have to argue what the current law says. They have to argue case law. They have to argue statutory law. And they have to argue legal facts. Debaters don't do that because that is specific knowledge and that's not the type of thing which is allowed in debate. What you as a debater should be doing is you should be arguing legal norms and legal principles which are related to law in themselves but which are general enough for any person to be able to rationally and critically analyze and use in an argument. What is considered general? Well, most people should at least have a general idea of constitutional practice, the fact that we have a court system in this country, the fact that we have a legislative system in this country where laws are made, and we have a Bill of Rights. These are the types of things which are generally in the news and which everyone should have an idea about, and if you don't, well, ignorance is no excuse under those circumstances. Specific knowledge is knowing what the transitional arrangements are for the New Companies Act, the type of thing which is almost never going to be relevant in debate unless you squirrel it to such a matter that you need to introduce it. Now, it's never a good idea to simply regurgitate arguments from case law, arguments from textbooks. So you should rather ask yourself, when introducing, as a law student, when introducing matter which you yourself have been taught in your course, at what point in time should it be relevant? And if it takes you longer than a couple of sentences to explain the concept or principle to an adjudicator or to the floor at large, chances are you shouldn't be using it and chances are it's specific knowledge. So those are the type of things which are do's and don'ts. Other do's and don'ts which you should avoid is trying to sound impressive, using legalese. If you can't use plain or simple language, chances are you run the risk of having specific knowledge. And if you use terms which you yourself don't understand, chances are there's someone in the room which do understand them, which will be able to take you onwards. Another common mistake when in a legal argument is overanalyzing or underanalyzing situations and simply oversimplifying them. Now, this is a risk for both law students and non-law students. For non-lawyers, it's very simple. They just simply dismiss everything which is legal in nature and say that it's specific knowledge. It's not as simple to do that. As we already said, ignorance of general legal principles is never an excuse in itself. If you want to use terms like unfair, unreasonable, unconstitutional, you better make damn sure that you actually know what that means. For lawyers, also make sure that you unpack these concepts, because the fact that it's been drilled into your head from day one doesn't necessarily mean that everyone else always knows what you're talking about, and therefore you shouldn't take that knowledge for granted. Another thing which commonly happens in legal debates, which you should watch out for, is circular argumentation or appeals to authority. Just because there is a law that says something is okay or says something is criminalized, doesn't mean you should simply appeal to that law. Always remember the law can change, and in debate you are arguing in the abstract. A lot of times you will be arguing normatively, so you can't just say, oh, because the law says you can't do it, you can't do it. The fact that someone argues something which is different from the status quo is in itself also not the problem. Rather look at what the law says, whether or not that's right and what the rights and the concepts behind the law is, and then argue and analyze those aspects rather than simply appeal to the law as it currently stands.